You know, sometimes I get a little overwhelmed by the world around us. Sometimes it doesn't seem to be going the way I'd like it to, and it's just such great relief and peace to know that He does love us. And I think I was long to see His glory. Don't you? There is just such a hunger to see Him. And I'm so grateful that's not unique to me. You know, Moses really wanted to see God's glory too. And he had an imposing task ahead of us, like we do, because our job is to share His love with this whole world around us. And I don't know about you, but one or two of the people near me aren't so lovely. And He asked God to show His glory. God said, I can't do that because it would be too much for you. But I'll tell you what. I will hide you in the cleft of the rock. And from there, you'll be able to see the afterglow of my glory as I pass by. And that'll be too much for you. But I will do that for you. And we look around us and we see that we need to understand that glory too. Because we so desperately need, as a church, to be revived, as God's church, as the bride of Christ. And this world needs that to happen in us so that they can see His glory. He's just made that really apparent to me in some really personal ways this week. And so, I would like for you to step into that cleft of the rock. And let's just worship Him together and thank Him for who He is with one of my favorite old hymns.